thinking of stuff about education. The fact is that it's a state of the process of education. That's what we're talking about in the process. But we're very happy to see that the professionals and students are actually in this education. And how we're also forcing this to make us in the last public debate about assessments through the work of the National Forum for the Advancement of Teaching. But also understanding the principles that this considers a business to the work that has been undertaken in the different institutions across the country. We also have a strong education leader in the assessment of the family of citizens and the stakeholders for all the state of federal system. I've chosen the metaphor of stuckness as a way of thinking through and framing the challenges that assessment poses in the higher education context. The paper said at times, the experience of stuckness not simply an expression of physical confinement or spatial closure, but expresses the way people make sense of confining their lives to practices. In adopting the stuckness metaphor, I argue that we need to reconnect with the practice of higher education. The access of education is viewed as having many layers, indeed, the debate is as old as this could expect. In recent times, two of the most prominent include qualifications, socializing, this overlap distinguishes and tensions between. John MacArthur, who is here with us today, condemns that higher education should facilitate a working way to the individual as solely from the practice of learning towards the institutions of society. Today's impression on our higher education system is the research that we expect from our disciplines and subjects are oriented towards society. This is the foundation of which higher education is founded. The enactment of that commitment is approached and portrayed differently by institutions, but approaches to assessment serve as steps this broader orientation so that we can, as the best providers, measure a positive value as opposed to value contribution. If our aim is to nurture students, that the disciplinary subject knowledge is not an end in itself, and seen as something that the community needs to contribute to broader society, that assessment that my father found to be responsive. Responsive assessments which enable students to see themselves as developing skills, knowledge, and dispositions, but by useful and social justice efforts, not just to create and spread promotion. If we want our students to value knowledge and research in a broader social context, then assessment is one of the clearest ways in which we benefit the students, but that is not the environment. This course is not a future partnership in the case of assessment. It should also be recognized that common thread running through assessment discourses is tension. Many aspects of assessment come into conflict between choices that are not reasonably related to context. However, the tensions cannot be resolved if they are not recognized, and only can be reconciled through proper explanation of what describes them. Decisions about assessment strategy and implementation need to be made for managing the power of assessment to drive learning and the values and choices of the institution. This requires a planned strategy, supported by consistent decision making and the allocation of effective resources. Different discourses have shaped assessment practice. Four major discourses dominate the literature: assessment competency, assessment literacy, assessment capability, and to a lesser extent, assessment identity, all of which have influenced the development of theories, policy direction, and the professional development of teachers and faculty, and the education experience of students and the development of educational institutions. These discourses emphasize different aspects of assessment and represent the complex picture of what it means for faculty and students to engage with the assessment process. Assessment competency generally refers to an active practice which promotes assessments that will support student learning. In this framework, assessment competency is context-dependent resources development. Assessment literacy is linked to assessment competency and the demonstration of clearly defined achievements. This discourse has been most influential in framing teachers' assessments assessment capability discourse by achieving less attention in the literature, but nevertheless made an important contribution. Assessment capability teaches the faculty have the knowledge and skills to modify the practice of the classroom and education, and support students to become self-employed again, with the focus on students' current and future learning. More recently, the discourse of assessment identity was announced in the literature. The 18th and 2013 teaches the term and reference the teacher students about the assessment practice. The meaning of the practice strongly expanded the concept to link with the literature and teacher identity, which focuses on teachers' personal and professional relationship with their assessment work, and developing a successful mind to represent cultural knowledge of students, knowledge of effective practice, and confidence in active assessment practices, which is based on prior experience. Now the knowledge research has been conducted on assessment identity for knowledge education. Claims of use argue that we require an expanded footprint, which emphasizes not only the practice of assessment, inclusive of the smarter practices and processes, but also the social context through dimensions, skills by faculty and states, the capable asking, the emotional labor of the question, faculty to faces, and school diversity. I argue that exploring faculty assessment identity is very necessary for higher education to understand the emphasis and behavior of faculty in the educational system. Research and ethics methodology suggests that if the practice crisis and determines those faculty members identity and expertise, this includes assumptions of advanced economic planning, class to be performed, standards for effective performance, patterns of publication, professional interaction, and social activity status. In addition, of course, academic identity is not static and changes over time and relates to the context of text and philosophy. It is also influenced by the structural and cultural context in which faculty operate. The structural context in which we operate is very challenging. There are many different dynamics, external expectations, governmental, shocks to the system, trends referred to in COVID-19, AI technologies, commentary about growth and system, expanded numbers and delays, cohorts of students, risk of subject expectations, precarity among colleagues, time poverty, and range of myriad tasks that require completely employment systems to be met. Greater and different colleagues contend that this structural context has led to more transactional and vision-based approaches to learning on the part of both faculty and students. There are also tensions between assessment of promotes learning and assessment of accountability. Affecting values, governance, employees, and state institutions to prepare students adequately for the world of work. And these requirements also need to be documented during the assessment process. It is also the case that institutions struggle to develop a holistic strategy that is coherent to the various requirements, approaches, and evidence required by stakeholders. KPIs face with testing, yet not always well-defined assessment demands. Members to select and use various indicators and instruments, such as student evaluation and teaching, and young experts. And there is a systematic connection between indicators and coherence to be measured. Top of contextualization of the overall effort of student and institute structures. Moreover, even quality of agencies are not always pleased with their expectations with regard to justice. The growth in student numbers has been partially attributed to the economies of scale and larger class sizes and to reduced class poverty. However, equivalent economies of scale, in assessment, are burden to compete. This reality has not changed with the demand. And as the impact of assessment delivered within this constraint context on student learning is considered to be very exciting. Knight argues that searching for efficiencies such as over-reliance on long-performance exams, kickbacks, feedback loops, and acting in increasing rates of learning outcomes for specialist leadership and business agendas have been led to be successful. The limitations of assessment methods are not the allocation of the necessary resources to reach them. Within institutions, assessment tends to reflect a multiplicity of interrelated aspects of concerns, and the complexity of context is needed to acknowledge the understanding of the overall of the institutional context. Unwritten rules and systems and practice, limitations in technology and resources, higher education systems and logistical constraints, like classroom is that gap reflected in the practice of self perspective? Are there limitations with the logic descriptors that Dr. Davis is? What is the quality of practice, central assessment schedule versus proper prize outside of the time of day? Are assessment tasks conducted with the way each practice and the overall assessment assessment density? These questions indicate that we need to develop a holistic approach to understand what is happening in the overall structure of context. Based on the structure of context is the type of the context of the institution. This includes attitudes of university students, many of whom are from society and many faculty do not emphasize these aspects. it's put your eyes to mind as a number of things that they have to do with the process of coming up with writing. I believe that students apply the students of assessment and they still are very important to understand the process of what we're going to do, but understand the assessment is practical enough to not work against the assessment. However, research suggests the reason for this. Students understand the improvement of assessment in group cases is going to depend on the extent to which the pedagogue is upholding the relationship between subject and student. Structural and policy factors can inhibit this kind of approach. If the goal for students to develop their own assessment of empathy, we need to think about students and view assessment as the way that we're going to get started. It's about the new assessment element, it's about taking the members of the disciplinary profession, and it's having a basis of the faculty find it difficult to express the assessment of empathy. Clients are now going to judge from other individuals based on how many topics and topics and assessments of assessment are done to them. The usual goal is to not assess me, to focusing on the nuance of the discipline, reconciling the nuance of the discipline with large practices, using a variety of assessment approaches, all students are granted in community. The response of individuals reflects the presence of people who are incentive in a structured context, a structured cultural context of the approach. So I started by arguing that stuckness as an introvert allows us to explore the profound benefits of the practices in our assessment landscape and think about how we need to address them. When we consider all of them in a structured and cultural cultural context, the kind of core of your learning, a fundamental part of the student's approach is promoting an assessment identity and faculty and students, which will allow meaningful conversations about learning and cognition. This approach will allow us to conduct constantly tracking through types of that assessment to demonstrate in a meaningful way the quality of assessment that drives the community contribution to learning. Our assessment approaches and the ecosystems in which they are developed, designed, and implemented. We will get